Good morning, my fellow Canadians. Thoughts for the day. I was reflecting on what went on recently with the blockades and the damage that did to the Canadian economy. How many good working, note the word working, Canadians were inconvenienced or lost money. Businesses that lost money because of this. It caused me to reflect on what is dying, words that are disappearing from the Canadian landscape. Honor, courage, moral certitude, patriotism, intelligence, common sense. I've said it before, I could weep, and I'm not indulging in hyperbole, or I could weep for what is happening to my Canada. This is not the country I served in uniform. This is not the country my father fought for. Look at the blockades specifically. We saw the spinelessness of politicians when I believe it was the Tamils who blocked the Gardiner Expressway. In Toronto, that's a major arterial. The cops wanted to go in and clean them out. What they did was illegal. Now, I understand they had a political agenda. There were other venues for this. You have a political agenda, have a town hall meeting, organize a rally, get a permit, organize a rally, see who shows up. Put it out in the newspapers, put it out in the media. You don't disrupt the lives of working Canadians for your political agenda. Now, I heard from a retired police officer that the spinelessness of Toronto City Council resulted in a lot of cops quitting. And understand this, as an ex-military cop, if I was prevented from doing my job for political considerations or for the optics, I would have been extremely angry. Why did you train me, hire me, and put me out there if you're not going to allow me to do my job? The good cops out there who take the sacred responsibility of protecting society and take it to heart and do it daily, day in, day out, to ensure that our society, the animals are kept at bay in our society, and then to be told, oh, don't do your job. Al-Quds rally, is it permitted? Do they have permits when they march? Or are they just mob rule? Is mob rule now to circumvent or to supplant the rule of law in Canada? Is that all it takes? Could we gather a bunch of, let's say, right-wing neo-Nazis or skinheads and block the tracks or block roads because we feel that we are not respected? What about a white power movement? The cops would have been in there, mounted units, police dogs, water cannon, everything. But because of the optics, the rule of law was circumvented. I was talking to friends of mine. They disagree with me on this one. I think we are long overdue for a politician. It has to come from the Conservative camp because the NDP and the Liberals, it will never happen by their very nature of their political platforms and their attitudes. We will never see this from those parties or the Greens. We need a good Conservative politician. We don't need a new party. We need a solid Conservative leader who will do, and I said, Trump-style politics with a Canadian flavor. Like Trump, hate Trump. Immaterial. What is the secret to his success? How does he appeal to so many people? The media kills it. The media does not report on the degree of support that he has in America, because they hate it. What he does, what he says, what is happening flies in the teeth of all their social theories and their beliefs. Well, your social theories and your beliefs have butted against hard reality, and the hard reality is he has a tremendous tide of support. Why? My personal opinion on this. Why is he so loved and supported and internationally respected? He speaks from the heart. He truly believes in a great United States of America. And he is truly working towards that goal. So he's not like the liberals, just tossing out word salad and pandering to the media or playing to the press. He is speaking from the heart. We need a Canadian conservative leader who will do that. Now, Andrew Scheer, I think his heart's in the right place. Unfortunately, the last campaign, they did a liberal-style campaign. Anybody who's ever done boxing, anybody who's ever been in a fight understands if you want to win, you have to fight your fight. If you play in your opponent's arena, if you fight your opponent's fight, you're going to lose. Personally, this is where I see the Conservatives fell down. We need a Canadian politician who will come across with a spine, who espouses those old Canadian values of courage, of moral certainty, who speaks to the Canadian people and who speaks from the heart. Bring some passion into Canadian politics. Get people out there to galvanize the Canadian people, because what you hear from most, you hear Trudeau giving a speech, and other than the you hear most conservative politicians give a speech, it's the same monotonous droning word salad that comes out of the Liberals or the NDP or the Green Party. No, that has to stop. The evidence is there. Boris Johnson in the UK. Look at the support. And we're not talking ultra-right-wing, neo-Nazi style, fascist style politics or politicians. We're talking about people who love their country and project this to the people. If you love this country, I'd love to see the next conservative slogan. I would love to see it. Let's save Canada. How do you like that for a conservative slogan for the next election? Let's save Canada. And get up there and speak from the heart. If you believe in this country, if you believe in what you're saying, if you believe in the rule of law, if you believe in courage, if you believe in patriotism, project it, speak it, shout it from the rooftops. My friends say emotionalism wouldn't work. Emotionalism like Trudeau style, that hijab hoax. Do you remember the tears? Bullshit. Alligator tears. I'm not talking about that emotionalism. I'm talking about a patriot who speaks from the heart, who speaks with passion, and who reaches out to the Canadian people and says, we have to get together and galvanize to save this country. Help us save Canada. For you and for your children and for the future of this country, that Canada should remain Canada. Help us save Canada. What do you think? I see spinelessness. The perfect example of what happens when you take elitists and academics and put them against hard reality. The blockades should have been dismantled the day they went up. The police should have been cut loose and said, remove them. That is illegal. Remove them by whatever means you must. Anybody tries to sabotage a train and they're caught, remove them by whatever force you have to use. Find them, imprison them. Convict them, imprison them. And if they get hurt, like, did you see that idiot standing on the train tracks and somebody's, the train's not stopping, the train's not stopping. And finally, I wish he'd have stood there and got hit. One less idiot. But the train just kept honking the horn and kept going. truck drivers who have run illegal blockades. And the cops are thinking of charging the truck drivers? What? My Canada is turned upside down. Illegal activity is ignored. And people who protest justifiably show moral courage, moral certainty in the face of unreasonable activism, face criminal charges. That's not my Canada. Should be lauded as a hero. Talked before about castle doctrine. We need a castle doctrine. A common misconception today, and again, thanks to the spineless politicians. Now, I know this for a fact because I have talked to police officers who have left, like mostly Toronto Police Force, but also OPP. I've talked to police officers who have been there, and they've gotten away from it because they left the force. Just recently, a lady in my building, police officer, she left the force. She had her time in. She wanted to remain a cop. She couldn't stand the politics. Nick, whoever, wherever you may be, it was a pleasure working with you on the last Conservative campaign for our candidate. He was offered or asked to apply for the sergeant's exam and sit for the sergeant's exam and take the promotion. He didn't want it. He didn't want to be involved in the politics. He wanted to be a good cop. And a lot of good cops out there we've lost because of, think of it, you're a police officer and the politicians will not let you do your job. How discouraging must that be? One thing about the police that I think a lot of Canadians are unaware of, the Supreme Court has determined, not once, but twice, a police officer does not have to put himself in harm's way to protect you. You got that? If you have, and a perfect example was the school shooting in, I believe it was Florida. The cops stayed outside while the shooter was shooting students in the school. He didn't enter and try to engage the shooter until he had backup, more people, and they waited around. Apparently, it was more than one cop. I heard it was four cops until SWAT and the tactical unit arrived. So you've got a shooter killing kids in the school, and the cops stood outside and sat on their hands. Now, in Canada, the Supreme Court said, yeah, that's fine. You don't have to put yourself in harm's way to protect the citizens. But we don't have the right as citizens to protect ourselves. Go ahead, protect yourself from theft, from assault, from a home break-in. And God forbid you use a firearm, because even if you are eventually exonerated, they will rake you over the coals. And think about this. You defend your home with a firearm, you kill a bad guy. The cops will confiscate all your firearms pending the result of the trial. Your license will probably be, if not lifted, at least suspended. They will take your firearms license, take your firearms pending the results of the trial. So now if the guys who invaded your place or who you shot have buddies, they know that you are now unarmed and not in a position to defend yourself. So if they decide to do a retaliatory comeback, you're helpless. Sure, call the cops. Be interesting to see. I wouldn't suggest doing this, but it would be interesting to see what the police response time is in your area. I know in rural Canada, it could be anything from 20 to 45 minutes. And yet, and I bring up again, Jack Wilson, the Texas church shooting. The guy who entered that church with a shotgun killed two people before Jack Wilson shot him. The whole episode lasted 6 seconds. That is your reactionary time frame. In a real world, the liberals and the academics are totally unaware of real world. We saw how they reacted again at the blockades. Real world, and they were helpless. They dithered and dawdled and what do we do now? What a bunch of clowns. any good Canadian, any true Canadian, would have said immediately, this violates the rule of law. So cut loose the cops. Break these up now. Arrest these people now. Nope. But yet some guy was walking next to the tracks, apparently, with his wife and kids, and he got a ticket. Oh, that, yeah, the police could react to that, right? There's a threat to public safety. Film, video footage of people trying to burn or destroy trains. What'd the cops do? Nothing. Because of the political optics. I don't know how recent this is. Tommy Robinson in the US, in Britain. It looks like his daughter was groped. 8-year-old daughter had her buttocks grabbed by some grown men. He can't say. Muslim, Pakistani Muslims. He's gagged from saying this. So he said East Asian, which is the British euphemism for Pakistani Muslims. 8-year-old daughter had her ass grabbed by grown men. He was arrested for detaining the guy. He was charged and arrested for detaining the man who tried to leave. The cops never arrested the groper. They never took his cell phone to see if there was any video evidence. They went after Tommy Robinson. The world is turned on its ear. You can't protect your 8-year-old daughter from being groped by some misbegotten, misogynistic Muslim? Really? And that is what's coming to Canada under the Liberals. That kind of stupidity. The one I brought up before, the West Edmonton Mall. Muslim man groping children, young girls in a pool at the West Edmonton Mall. Not even a day in jail. Released because the freaking moronic judge said, well, cultural differences led him to do this and he didn't know it was wrong. One of the oldest quotes I grew up with, ignorance of the law is no excuse. Having lived and worked in foreign countries, one of the first things you learn, if you want to stay out of trouble, learn the mores, learn the laws, learn what is and is not acceptable in that culture. It's incumbent upon you to do this if you wish to stay out of prison. Well, not in Canada, not under the Liberals. That's not my country. That's not my Canada. So, where am I going with this? More observations and notes on spinelessness, which is what I'm going to entitle this video, Spinelessness. The death or the deterioration of Canadian values. So if you love this country, open your eyes, galvanize, get active, get others active to save this country. If you truly love this country and you truly wish to enjoy the benefits of Canada and the benefits of being a Canadian, act and galvanize others to act. Please. Thank you. Have a good day.